How's it going, guys? Check out this new After Effects tutorial. After you're done, you're gonna be able to make a video that looks just like this. I'm gonna apologize, this tutorial was recorded in a very loud environment. It was right in the middle of downtown Los Angeles at my friend's apartment. So you're gonna hear a lot of sirens and street noise and everything, but sit back and relax, that's all just part of the game, and enjoy this new tutorial. All right, so forgive me, I'm currently filming in my friend's apartment, so you can hear the loud ambient sounds of downtown Los Angeles. You'll just have to be prepared for that. But I think this is gonna be a really cool tutorial. I'm completely doing this tutorial from memory as well, so this may not be a completely step-by-step, straightforward tutorial. I may take a moment to actually figure out what the heck I need to do. So we're currently here in Premiere, and we're going to deal with our base footage. Check this out, we're gonna play through our base footage right here. Film this in South LA, two friends dancing. And so what we're gonna do is we're going to start with creating a bunch of stills. So let's see here. Let's pick a still right here. Let's do this. And then we're gonna go and create a export a frame. Let's call it one. Export another frame by clicking on the export frame camera button. Call it two. We're gonna do the same thing for a few more frames. Call that one four, make sure it's a PNG. PNG is gonna give you a lot more information. It's gonna be a better photo than like say a JPEG, perfect. All right guys, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go and we're gonna import those four stills into Premiere. Cool, and then one by one, we're going to line up the stills with where they are in, with where they were captured in this video. So what I'm gonna do is you know, we have the actual video, and then I want to line up this still where it was captured. So I'm going to actually go to opacity. I'm going to bring it down to like 50-ish, and I'm going to try to see where it lines up. Looks like it's lined up right here, perfect. And then I'm going to cut this still back to the point where it lines up at that point. And I'm going to make sure that the back of the still is always just on the back. Cool. So basically, what you're gonna do is you're gonna do the same thing for all the other stills. I'm gonna do it again, just in case you didn't understand. So let's do this first. Let's line up the back of the still to the back of the actual video. Okay, and then let's click on the opacity, bring it down to like 50-ish, just so you can see both. We're gonna see where it lines up. It lines up right there, perfect. And then we're gonna cut the other half, the right half of the still, back to where it lines up so that you cut you're basically cutting the right half of the still directly to where it lines up, where you found it lined up. And then you're gonna click on this, you're gonna bring the opacity back up. You may be wondering, why am I doing this? It's gonna make sense in a second. We're gonna do the same thing for the third still. Let's bring the opacity down to like 50%. Yeah, 50-ish%, 50, let's be at 60%, it doesn't really matter, opacity. And now we're going to find the place where it lines up, right there. Oh, forgot to bring this to the end. The end always goes to the back for the still, but it's the right end where you need to cut it back directly to where it lines up. I'm gonna do the same thing for the fourth one. All right, if you guys remember, opacity down. All right, and we're gonna wait for it lines up right there, I think, perfect. Let's bring the opacity back up to 100%. I'm gonna cut this back to where it lined up, and perfect. So what you have now is you have four photos that line up with exactly where they, with exactly where their frames are, corresponding frames are in the actual video on the right side of the photo. So you may be wondering, what's the point of that? I see a little bit of, okay, this saw a little bit of transparency. I'm gonna make sure all these are at 100%. Make sure that's at 100% too. That's at 100%. Perfect. Now what we're gonna do is we're going to highlight everything. We're gonna right click and we're gonna go into After Effects, replace with After Effects composition. I really hope that all you guys watched the part one, or I don't know if we can call it part one, but basically it's the beginner After Effects tutorial that I have. I'll link it in the bottom. That'll show you how to do all this stuff that we're about to get into, masking and everything. We're going to go over it again in this tutorial. Let's call this After Effects project AAA, just because it doesn't really matter. Cool. So we're going to try to go as fast as we can while still going slow enough so that you understand what's happening. We are now in After Effects now. Cool. Oh, what did I just do? Okay, cool. Go back to where it was before. So now everything has been duplicated in After Effects. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, all these photos. We have the video footage underneath. First thing we're going to do is we're going to actually start masking him out of this photo. So we're going to use the mask, the pen tool. To mask, use the pen tool like you saw in the After Effects beginner tutorial. And we're going to just start cutting him out of all of these photos. Just him, though. Cool. And what we're doing is, as we're cutting him out, we're creating these little, we're creating, as you saw in the beginning, the example video, all those kind of stills that kind of are present at the beginning and that go away as soon as his normal footage gets to that point. If you remember, the cool thing about this video, or the final video, is you have all these like pictures, like still versions of him that are present, and then as soon as the video portion of him gets to that still, it pops away. It almost like eats the stills up. Cool. So now we're going to blind this one. First, I want to just show you. Let's see. It's kind of, you can't really see because you can, there's stills now. So I'm going to blind this still, and now you can see we're going to work on three. We're going to cut him out of this still, and the plan is we're going to actually try to cut him out of all these stills so that you can actually see the video underneath. You can't really see the video underneath at this point because there's only stills. All the stills are on top of each other. So when you cut a still out like you're doing now, instead of seeing the video, you're going to just see all the other stills before we cut him out of all the stills, if that makes sense. Cool. We're going to try to be a little bit careful. A little bit neat in the way that we're cutting. If you ever make a mistake as far as laying down one of these masking points, you just do Control Z on a PC or Control Z on or Command Z on a Mac, and you can undo it. Okay, we've cut out 3, 4, and 3 now. Let's blind 3. Let's go to 2. Cut out 2. Another little trick, guys, is if you want to go to your hand tool to go to another portion of the image, hold down space bar, as I just did, and you can use the hand tool to drag up to another portion of your image so you can continue masking it out. I'm going to do space bar again, just dragged it back up. There we go. And then when you take off space bar, it automatically goes back to your selection tool. I remember the first time I ever learned how to mask like this was as an intern for a video production company. My friend Kavika actually taught me how to mask, and we're actually masking. We're doing a bunch of VFX for the Chris Brown documentary. You guys should check it out on Netflix. Okay, cool. All right, guys, so let's unblind all this so you can see all of these things that we just did. Perfect. Make sure this is all right. So guys, what you can see here, perfect, okay, cool. So what you can see is, let's do this. Let's bring the resolution down to quarters so stuff can play. Oh, wow, there we go, cool. It's playing pretty crappy now. I'm gonna try to go to let's go to half resolution. So guys, as you can see, as he goes backward, this is the video layer, right? As he goes backward, let's try full so it's crisp. As he goes backward, he is going to eat all of these images because the way that the stills are placed, they're placed right where they have their corresponding still in the video that's underneath. Perfect. I want to have, like, say, these arms. I want to kind of have these arms moving. I don't want it to necessarily seem like these are just stills. I want them to actually seem alive. So I want his arms to move even before these stills to move before they get eaten up by the video. How do you do that? It's going to be pretty easy. My apologies. Before we do that, I want to fix one more thing. I just see some stuff that's bothering me. It's these details, guys, that will really make you be appreciated by your client. When you see details that need to be done, that need to be cleaned up, you actually clean them up. Your client will appreciate you. All right, here we go. I just wanna, if you see this, I don't wanna see that edge. I'm gonna tighten that tiny bit. All right, that's fine. That'll have to be fine. Okay, cool. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pick, so let's say this one. For this one, I want this arm to actually move. So let's blind all these top tracks so we can actually see what's happening. And I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna actually duplicate this track. Okay, and then I'm gonna go to here and I'm gonna actually delete, oops, let's undo what I just did. I'm gonna go to the bottom number two picture and I'm gonna do this. I'm gonna delete all of these mask points like that. Perfect. And then I'm gonna go to the duplicated number two right here, and I'm gonna delete all, let me undo that. I'm gonna delete all the opposite mask points that I just deleted. So I deleted the arm in the previous, in the original version, and then this copied version, I'm gonna delete the body. There we go. So if I do this, you can see in the bottom, the original number two photo or still, it's the body, and in the duplicated number two still, it's the arm. Now, why did I do that? It's pretty easy. You're gonna figure this out in a sec. So I'm gonna extend this a little bit over here. I'm gonna basically, what I did was I split him up into two pieces. So now I'm just gonna keyframe the motion so that his arm moves. How do I do that? Well, first I need to make sure, I need to find out where my anchor point is. My anchor point is right here. I want my anchor point to be right here so that everything, because everything's gonna rotate around my anchor point, and I want to make sure that everything's rotating around his shoulder. So if I do rotation now, it's gonna rotate around there, which sucks. I'm gonna undo that. So I'm gonna go to my anchor point, and I'm gonna make sure that my anchor point is where I want it to be. Right there, right where his shoulder is. Let's go a little bit like that way. Cool. Now I'm gonna go to my position. So notice the difference between anchor point and position. I'm controlling my position now. And now if my anchor point is right here at his shoulder, let's see if this works. Actually, I want my anchor point to be a little bit over there. Change the position here. Perfect. So now if I go to rotation again, things are gonna rotate like this, and it's gonna be cool. Kinda looks like his arm's rotating, right? Cool, so I'm gonna start here. I'm gonna create a keyframe rotation, and I'm gonna rotate it to like here. So cool, I'm gonna put this keyframe at the very beginning, and put this keyframe at the very end, so that over the course of this thing, his arm's gonna actually rotate, if you can see. Let's bring these other masks up. Now you can kind of see the arm rotating, which is pretty cool, right? Pretty cool. All right, so I'm gonna speed up this video and I'm gonna do the same thing for a few of these other shapes. So bear with me here. All right, guys, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna actually go into this one, I want some movement in here. I'm not quite sure what I'm gonna do. I think I might move his head somehow. So I'm gonna duplicate this. I'm gonna take his head off of the bottom one, just so it's the body. There we go. I'm gonna go up to the top one and I'll do the opposite. to do that. Control Z, Control Z. Let's move the body out. Zoom out. Take all that out. There we go. Now it should just be his head. Cool. Awesome. So now it's like that. Let's bring this down a tiny bit. Okay. Should be split in half, half and half. Okay, so what we're gonna do then is, again, we're gonna go to anchor point. Where is the anchor point? Anchor point's way down there. So wow, we gotta do a little bit of shifting. Shift the anchor point to the back of his neck. Do that. All right, it's going middle of his neck. Let's do that. We're gonna put the position back up. Just took his head off. We're gonna put his head back on now. Zoom in, scroll in with the mouse. Should align that up pretty good. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna now rotate based off of that new anchor point. Let's create a keyframe here. Let's create another keyframe here. Let's go back to that first keyframe and let's have his head go down so that he's effectively tilting up. Let's stretch that keyframe to the end so that right when he pops in, it seems to work. We'll see how this looks. A lot of this is trial and error, guys. The other actual video that you saw, it was all different because I'm doing this all from scratch. So, cool. All right. So, all right. This kind of works. I could have done this a little bit neater. I think in the final video, I kind of did those. I was kind of a little bit better with the masks for these. I think for this one, I'll go in maybe and I'll do this to clean this mask up, watch. I'll go to mask, and then I'll, in mask expansion, I'll bring it in a tiny bit. -3, cool, I'll clean it up a little bit. Let's go to this one right here. Go to the body of image number 3, let's go to mask expansion, and let's bring that mask in. This is just gonna bring all those pixels in by like 3 pixels. Take that edge off. There we go. That's a little bit neater than before. Cool. So what I'm gonna do now is these photos kind of cool, look cool now. You see they're all kind of moving, but they're kind of static. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually create a null object that I'm gonna use to track them and make them kind of move with the camera. So I'm gonna do null object. What a null object is, it's pretty easy to figure out. It's literally just a object that is going to hold a bunch of track points. Let's undo what I just did. So, oh no, what did I just do? There we go. Zoom back in. Keyboard's messing up. All right. Go back to the null object. There we go. Okay, cool. I'm gonna track. So you just need to find a place to track. I'm gonna track the head of this little sliver of wood. And you may be wondering, okay, what am I doing? You'll figure it out in a sec. I could auto track this, but I'm gonna manually track it, which means I'm gonna go in. I keyframed the position, and I'm literally going every so often and writing the position back to where it should be so that theoretically, this null object will always be on this sliver, the top of this sliver of wood. I'm just gonna grab it. You can grab the null object from anywhere. Perfect. Right here, that should be enough keyframes to keep it pretty level. So yeah, it seems to track. We seem to have tracked it pretty well on that little piece of wood. That means that this is now pretty much attached into my scene. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm going to parent all my photos to this null object. And that's going to, I'm gonna actually do it first, then I'm gonna tell you what it does. Parenting, you have this little parent Pickwick thing. And you're going to make sure that each one of these is parented to the null. When it gets parented, you see that null goes right there. And what it's basically doing is, as you're parenting each of these stills that you've masked out to this null, it's gonna basically, these stills are going to take on these position keyframes that you've put on the null. So it's gonna basically follow the null. And as you can see, these, you can see they're kind of moving now with the camera, which is making it a little bit more realistic. So what I'm going to do though is, while these are moving with the position keyframes of the null, I want to go in and just create a little bit more movement. So for example, I'm going to go into the transform. Let's go into position. And we're going to move this a little bit this way. That might have been too much, but we'll see. I'm going to move this the other way, actually. Let's delete this keyframe. And then move this way a tiny bit. It's a little bit too fast. I make the position a little bit less. Okay, that might work. It's a little bit too fast still. Okay, so we're gonna go and add some blur. Blur. Okay, so we're gonna go to blur. And we're gonna go to Gaussian blur. And we're gonna add a Gaussian blur to one of these. Which one? Let's choose first. So let's go to the outer one, let's go to 4. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna keyframe the blur. This is gonna give this just a little bit of a 3D element because it's gonna seem a little bit out of focus. I want this further one to be the most out of focus at first. So I'm gonna go into effects. And I'm gonna go into blur and I'm gonna keyframe the blur. So let's keyframe the blurriness from 14 down to 0. And I'm gonna bring the 0 key point all the way at the very end. It's gonna go from 14 to 0. We're gonna go to this one right here. And we're gonna put blur on it as well. And we're going to, I'll have this one be at 14 as well. And we're gonna keyframe down. Oops, let's create that keyframe. Then we're gonna go down to 0. Alrighty. Cool. Alrighty. We're gonna do the same thing for this one. What I'm actually gonna do is I'm gonna just copy this effect. You can do Control C, and then we're gonna go down to over here. We're gonna copy it, or paste it, I mean. That didn't work. Let's do it again. Control C, Control V, paste. Perfect. Look at how these keyframes look. Now I'm copying it, I just pasted it on the body now for 3, because I had pasted it onto the arm before. Cool, we're gonna do the same for 2. Let's clean this up a little bit. Let's go just to 2. And let's paste this effect on 2. Go into Gaussian blur, and we'll see, let's bring this keyframe to the edge right there. Cool. Copy this effect in the beginning, copy, and paste. Cool. That seems to be working pretty well. Okay, we're gonna go to 1 and copy the effect as well. I'm copying the blur. Let's copy it down here as well. Copy that blur. Bring the keyframe for the blur to the very edge for both of them. There we go. Okay, cool. Let's see how this looks. It's pretty good. What do you guys think? The thing that's kind of bothering me a little bit is this, that you can kind of see the edge of this mask right here. So what I'm going to actually do is I'm going to go in here and do a little fix. Watch. This mask is just a little bit not done right. So I'm going to actually go into this mask. I'm going to actually change it a little bit. There we go. It's a little bit cleaner now. Perfect. Perfect. That's looking really good, guys. Let's go back to fit. All right, guys. So we see all of these. So as he, he's going into each of these photos and then eating them up as he goes past. And guys, that's basically it. That's how you do this. It's pretty easy. And what I did in the main video, if you remember, is I did the exact same thing with the girl. And I made a really, it's really loud, there's a horn going on. And I made a really cool little effect. I'm gonna do a few other things, guys. I'm not gonna do the girl, but I want to show you some other things that I did. What I did was, I know I did this. I nested everything. It's pre-composed, it's called pre-composing in After Effects. It's called nesting in Premiere. And then what I did was I actually did this. I believe I just keyframed the scale. So first I zoomed in and then I put a keyframe on the scale and the position. And then I did these type of things where it like zoomed in really quick. And then you can actually adjust the position as well. So let's see how that, this looks. Boom, boom, boom. And then like you can zoom out. You can do basically whatever you like. You can add some cool effects. It kind of looks like the camera's coming out, right? And then going in and then coming back out. And that's pretty much it, guys. If you want to go, let's go back to the original thing that I did and that I did before. See some other things that I did. I'm back in Premiere now. I added a little lens flare on top. I keyframed the, I put an adjustment layer over everything and I keyframed the saturation. So I went from like being undersaturated to normal saturation. You can do all that. As you can see here, I did the same thing for the girl in this first one that I did to him. And then in here, I did the same thing to his arm in the second one. So as you can see, his arm's kind of doing the same thing where I just got a bunch of stills. Did the same thing with his legs for the other one. It's pretty cool. I want to take note that for this one, let's go to his feet. For this one, you can see that I just duplicated, you know, his legs like I did for the other, I did in the other one, but I actually tracked his legs to the environment again. So I just picked any like point, like I think I picked here, and I made sure that as the camera went down and up, that these stills that I cut out were still gonna be tracked to the camera so that they would move as the camera moved. And it actually would seem like, you know, they were staying in place as the camera moved. So it actually seemed like they were in the same environment, if that makes sense. So that's pretty cool. All right, guys, I think that's all we're gonna cover. One other thing I'll say that I did that I just wanna mention is, I added an expression. I added a wiggle expression. So it seems like, bam, if you can see the ground shook a little bit. I have covered wiggle expressions in past tutorials. I'll make sure to link maybe the tutorial in the bios, and you can understand how to use the wiggle expression in After Effects. You could either use the expression or you could just literally keyframe the position really fast. We should all know about keyframes at this point. Guys, thanks so much for watching. This was kind of a long tutorial. It's really loud here in downtown LA. There's sirens every 2 minutes. But thank you so much for watching. Hey guys, before we go, of course, I gotta rep my sponsor, Envato Elements. Envato Elements is an awesome subscription service for only $33 a month that gives you unlimited downloads for numerous transition packs, title packs, effects packs, VFX packs, stock footage, literally anything you can think of. I just directed and edited this dope music video where I used an Envato Elements title pack for all the beginning titles. Check it out right here. It's all available in the link below. Please check it out. Every subscription helps the channel. Feel free to like this video, click subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Thanks so much for watching, guys, again. And as always, remember to keep it chill. We got a really good looking snow. We got a